Meet Brontoscorpio. His kind may look like modern scorpions, but they're a meter long and have gills. The arthropods have upped their game. These monsters have a superior armory to Anomalocaris, a stinger the size of a light bulb. Scorpions are the top predators in the Silurian seas, and prey is plentiful in their seabed hunting ground. Brontoscorpio zeroes in on his next meal. With her defensive headgear, Cephalaspis can't swim fast for long. She must rest frequently. Soon, she'll tire completely. Cephalaspis suddenly changes her path. She's picking up bad vibrations, something Brontoscorpio can't detect. But the fish have underestimated their enemy. It is the arthropods and not our ancestors who have taken the first momentous steps out of the sea onto dry land. Brontoscorpio has a huge advantage. As well as gills, he has simple lungs made up of hundreds of thin layers of tissue. He can't breathe in and out like we do. He just absorbs the oxygen into his blood. Equipped to maximize the little oxygen available, and with their armor to protect them from the sun, the scorpions patrol the shoreline, scavenging on whatever the sea washes up next. But the exhausted Cephalaspis have company. Passing scorpions have stumbled on this bounty. But the fish have numbers on their side. The clever Cephalaspis have navigated their way, while Brontoscorpio are only here by luck. They're soon stuffed to the gills, while the fish keep jumping. One scorpion is still hungry, but he can't feed. He's become a prisoner in his own skin. His rigid skeleton is now a handicap. It can't grow with his body. He needs to shed his hard skin and then grow another, expanding while the new one is still soft. For such a large creature, this is a long process. Next morning, there's no sign of life in the spawning pool. The scorpion has missed his chance.